Lindy said you wanted to see me.
Yes, are you the grade three teacher?
Miss Harris.
I'm looking for Debbie. Debbie Smith.
I'm afraid I don't know her.
Well, maybe she's in another class. Could you ask around?
Well, there's just one grade three, and I certainly know everyone in it. Are you sure she's in that grade?
Well, I ought to know. I'm her mother. Look, she's been going here ever since she started school. Deborah Smith. She's 8 years old. Pretty little thing.
And you're her mother?
Yes, I thought I'd pick her up after school.
But school was out over an hour ago.
Look, she does go here. I know she does. I tell you, she goes to school here. Well,
why don't you see if she's gone home,
Debbie is dead. Debbie is dead. Dead, dead.
Debbie. Debbie!
I can't find her.
Bea.
Look, first you tell me Debbie's dead, and then you tell me you'll help me find her.
Bea, you've got to get away from here.
You're the only person I send to Dan will know.
Bea, I can't help you anymore. If you went to a doctor...
You gone crazy.
No. No, it's just that he'll be able to help you to remember.
Remember? Remember what? That Debbie's dead? You're a liar. I ought to know whether she's alive or not. I'm her mother.
Please, Bea, the police have been here twice. You've got to go.
Look, if it's the money I took last night, I'm sorry. I stayed at a motel, but my husband will pay you back.
No, that doesn't matter. Here, take this. It's all I've got, but I can't help you anymore.
Hold it right there. I figured if we watched this place, you'd be back.
What are you doing?
Now, to make an interesting case against you too, Mrs. Brooks, helping a wanted crim to escape, you're under arrest.
Brooks.
Hello, Miss Bennett.
We could have you dragged out, Smith. Now move.
Bea.
I hope you enjoyed your little jaunt, Smith. It'll be the last for quite some time.
Leave me alone.
Please, Miss Bennett. Come on, Bea. You'll be all right.
Come on.
Now strip off and get ready for the showers.
Well, you don't expect me to get changed with you standing there, do you?
You'll do as I say, or I'll have it done for you. Some of the wind's been knocked out of your sails. Not that I'm surprised. You'll have at least 5 years added to the 10 you've still got to serve.
What is it that everyone thinks I've done? If someone would just tell me.
Will it be all right if I keep my watch? I don't want to have to rely on the officers telling me when to take my tablets.
No! No! I haven't killed anyone, I haven't! But I swear, I don't know what she's talking about. Please, please, believe me!
You murdered your husband, Smith. 24 hours after being released for murdering your husband's lover.
Are you listening to me, Smith?
I wouldn't do anything to hurt my family. I couldn't!
Oh, that's very good, Smith. You must have been very busy at Barnhurst practicing this little routine.
Please, will you tell this woman to lay off me?
That's enough, Smith.
I think solitary will refresh her memory.
Thank you, Miss Bennett.
Come on. Please stop grabbing at me!
Get another officer to give you a hand.
Well, what do you think?
Where's Mrs. Brooks? Why can't I be put in with her?
After what you did, she won't want anything more to do with you, Smith.
I didn't know she was on parole.
Of course not. You just went to her because she was the only one stupid enough to believe your performance.
Look, what have I ever done to you? Or you like this with everyone?
Let's see if I can't jog your memory for you. Starting with your daughter.
What do you know about Debbie?
I was here when they told you that she died from an overdose. Remember?
She couldn't possibly be on drugs, I'd know. You're a liar.
Come on, Vera, that's enough. Just stay out of this. I want to see how long she can keep up this charade.
Well, count me out.
Please, please, just leave me alone.
But I want you to remember, Smith, how you felt when you heard she was dead. You wanted to go to her funeral, but I wouldn't let you because you couldn't be trusted even then.
But Jack would know. He would have stopped it. He loves her.
You were such a close family, weren't you?
Well, of course we were. All right, we had a fight a few days ago, but he's been flirting with one of the girls from work. I'm only human.
You blamed your husband for letting Debbie die, alone like that, of an overdose. Or at least that's why you said you murdered him. There again, he was always having sordid affairs. But of course you know that. That's why you murdered his mistress.
Stop it! Stop it!
Shall I go on, or is it coming back now?
You rotten bitch. You rotten, lying bitch!
I've waited a long time to break you, Smith. If you're playing games and I prove it, you'll have another 5 years to look forward to. But just in case you're not, I'll always be around to help you remember. Either way, I win.
God, it's good to see you. It's been murder in here without you. Like living in a madhouse.
Who are you?
Oh, yeah, I forgot. But you got no need to worry. I won't give you away and the screws can't hear you.
Screws?
Oh, fair go, B. We're in awful strife in here with Margot. She tried to kill Jude. When you get out of here, you gotta fix her good and proper.
Get away from me.
What?
Leave me alone.
Just leave me alone!
Can we sit by ourselves?
They're your friends, B. They care about you.
Liven it up a bit, will you? Margot's watching.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I always say.
Stop. This is Judy, Doreen, and Liz.
Hi, B.
How you feeling, love?
We've already met.
This lot should bring back a few memories, Smith. I take it you're still playing your stupid game.
I think she's taken about as much as she can from you, Miss Bennet.
You're very protective of someone who's responsible for you being back here.
I'm responsible for my own mistakes.
Oh, not even a touch of bitterness.
Bitterness is soul-destroying, as you well know.
Yeah!
We'll work back an hour for being insolent, all of you.
Hey, B, how about you trying to read my tea leaves, and then you could sort of find out what we've been doing while you're away?
Yeah, like remembering how we all went on a hunger strike so you could come back from Barnhurst.
Will you lay off, Lizzie?
Come on, B, you can read tea leaves, can't you?
Yes, I can read them.
See, I gotcha. You do remember, don't you? You were having us on all the time.
No, I always read them at home for Debbie. It makes her laugh. Well, what do you want me to do?
I'm sure one of the others will help you.
You could help us fold sheets if you like.
I'm giving the orders around here.
What do you think about that?
I don't have to take orders from anyone.
You work the sewing machines or I'll smash your teeth in.
You come near me and I'll report you to the officers.
Yesterday, I was a wife and mother, and today I've got no daughter, no husband, and I'm told I'm dangerous and I've killed two people. And you ask me if I can accept it?
We'll get some help for you, Bea.
Just get me out of this madhouse. They've ruined my whole life. What more do they want?
I'll come back and see you later.
Seeing as how I was meant to have nicked it, I reckon you won't miss it now.
I need it and I'm keeping it.
Oh, no, don't hurt her!
Get out of here!
You bitch!
I couldn't have done it. I'm not a killer. I didn't kill anyone. I didn't. What are you all doing to me? Oh.
I can't help it unless you tell me what happened.
I nearly killed the woman in the laundry.
What?
Oh. The others call her Margot.
All right, take it easy. Look, just calm down.
Look, I think she's all right. Oh. I don't know. This place is riding me mad.
All right, take it easy. Just take it easy.
You've got to let me out.
Look, you just come with me and we'll see if she's okay.
Look, you get the woman that said she'd help me. Get the woman, please find
what
her.
Woman?
I don't know who she is. She was wearing street clothes.
The parole officer, Mrs. Morris.
Yes, I think
all
that's
right,
her.
Look, I'm not going to hurt you. I'm not going to hurt you. Calm down. Quiet.
Can't you get me out of here?
All right, you just come with me. We'll just take it easy. Now, come on. Just calm down.
For God's sake, won't you please do something to help me get out of here? Please.
I can't work miracles, Bea, you know that.
Well, I don't know. No one will believe me. I don't know.
But your record, the things you've done in the past.
Look, like what? Please, let me hear it from you.
This is very difficult, Bea. You must realise that. I mean, I know you as a different person. Normally, you wouldn't even ask me these questions.
But I'm not that person. I'm Bea Smith. Won't you understand that? Oh, why won't anyone believe me?
If you can't remember who you are...
But I can. I'm Bea Smith. I just told you that.
All right. If you can't remember who we think you are, how did you remember where Mum Brooks lived?
I don't know. I get flashes, but I can't make head and a tail of them.
What about that attack in the laundry just now?
I had to do that. They threatened Mum.
Yes, but why you? Why not one of the others?
Well, someone had to protect Mum. I didn't want to, but somehow I knew it had to be me. And then I found myself wanting to do it. I wanted to strangle her. I wanted to kill her.
And then you ran away.
Stop asking me to remember.
But you must.
No, I won't. Not those things. No!
Me, don't.
Me. You can't get me out. Get me out. Let me
out. Let
me out.
No. Let me out.
No.
Alone.
I've never felt like that before. It just all welled up inside me like the violence wanted to take over. I don't know what made me attack her. Perhaps I didn't. Maybe I didn't attack her at all.
Bea, it did happen. You mustn't lose sight of that. I know you don't like to think you're capable of such a thing, but it wasn't a dream. It was very real. And you, Bea Smith, are capable of much more than you seem to think.
Hey, Bea, come over here a minute.
Miss Smith doesn't look too well to me. You're not still on about that, are you? It's all part of her act, Terry.
Hey, alone! Why did you do that?
Get back there.
She attacked me for no good reason. Get her out of here. She's bloody raving mad.
Well, what's this about another fight?
Well, I know less about it than you do, Mrs. Davidson. I was completely set up.
Smith, Lizzie is your best friend. Why would she, of all people, set you up?
Well, who says she's my best friend? Don't I have any say in that? I don't know why she always picks on me. She's always hovering around.
Well, you consider Mum your friend. Why not Lizzie? You've known both women equally as long.
Well, there you go again. You're always saying that I do this or I do that. Everyone seems to know about it except me. Look, I'm just not the person you think I am. I shouldn't be here.
Yes, well, there's obviously no point in carrying this conversation on any further until I've spoken with Birdsworth. Would you take Smith back, please, Mr. Harrison?
Right, Smith.
Well, I'm just an ordinary housewife. Well, not really. I mean, I'm a hairdresser during the day, but well, that still means I have to go home and do the cooking and cleaning and get tea at night.
Does your daughter help you?
Well, I can't expect much of her. She's just a kid. And Jack doesn't do much around the house. But that's okay, I suppose. I mean, he works pretty hard during the day.
People have been telling you lately that Jack and Debbie are dead, haven't they?
Yes.
What was your reaction to that?
Well, what do you reckon? I mean, I know they were alive a couple of days ago. And yet everyone in this madhouse tells me they've been dead for years. It was like being in the middle of a nightmare. Look, Doctor, if someone would just get in touch with my husband, he's got money. I know he'd get a good solicitor or whatever's necessary.
Yes, all right, all right. We'll come back to that in a minute. I want to hear more about this, what you call a nightmare. This fight with Margot Gaffney. How did that come about?
Well, I don't even know it really happened. I can remember having my hands around someone's throat and squeezing. I wanted to kill them. I mean, I really wanted to kill them. And then what was worse is I felt I had the power to do it. I mean, inside me, it just... Oh, it scared me.
Tell me about these flashbacks.
Nothing to tell, really. It's like going to a place you've never been to before and everything's familiar.
No, but what were they like? I mean, what did you see?
Well, I remember seeing a woman being killed during an argument. And I remember Mum's place. Well, no, not her place or the address. That came later. But the number. I didn't remember her. I still don't. Even when I got there, I had to ask her if she knew me. And at times I feel closed in. And everything's black. Nothing. Yet I know there is something there. Something solid.
Anything else? What about Karen Travers? Frankie Doyle?
Oh, I've heard some of the other prisoners mention the last name, but it doesn't mean anything to me.
What would you do if you suddenly found out that Debbie was addicted to heroin?
Well, nothing. It just wouldn't happen. I mean, Debbie's not that sort of kid.
No, I mean, just for a moment, suppose that she did. What would you feel? Hatred?
Towards Debbie?
No, to the person who enticed her. What would you want to do? Would you want to lash out at him?
I don't know. I wouldn't be very happy. I mean, no one would. Well, I suppose I'd ring the police. I mean, that's what they're there for, isn't it? Look, Doctor, I don't think you understand. I've got a good husband and a lovely daughter. Now, why would I want to spoil that?
Oh, I'm all right, Doreen, really.
Ah. How'd you go, B?
Yeah, come and tell us all about it, B.
You just leave me alone.
Now, calm down, B. Sit down. They mean no harm.
Yeah, well, after this morning, you could have fooled me.
How do you feel?
Exhausted. You wouldn't believe all the questions.
And what's the outcome to be?
I don't know. I didn't let on.
Well, you don't think Weissman's going to be any different from any other witch doctor we've had in here. Don't worry. You'll be the last one to know.
Well, as long as you put it over him, that's all that matters.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's all right, B. They're only trying to help.
Oh, really? Well, you got me into trouble this morning, and I don't like that. So if you want to help me, leave me alone!
The woman I spoke to this afternoon is an innocent woman. Innocent of any crime. She hates violence. Now, should I try and bring her out of it? Should I bring back B. Smith murderers? Or should I leave her as she is and argue for an early release?
No! No!
Oh, Bean. Bean, now what is it? Come on. It's only a dream. It's only a dream. Now wake up.
Well, oh, Mom.
Well, you're all right.
I'm still in prison. No, I am still in here.
Yes, but help is coming. Now, come on. Now, back to sleep.
Mom? Mom? Oh, God.
Smith, what's all...
It's Mum. She's collapsed. Why, I came back from the showers. I found her in the cell.
Stand back from the bed.
Come on. Will you hurry up? She said she wasn't well this morning. I shouldn't have left her on her own.
Mrs. Brooks. Mrs. Brooks. Where are tablets?
Keeps them over here.
But they're not here.
We'll find them. They must have pulled them down behind there somewhere.
No, there's no time. Just go down and get the sister. Tell her what happened and tell us to bring some insulin.
Oh, where is it?
Where's what?
The hospital.
Oh, for God's sake, Smith, there's no time for this nonsense. Go and get the sister.
I don't know where it is.
Listen, Smith, this woman's supposed to be your friend. You want
her
to die?
Please, believe me, I never been to the hospital. I don't know where it is.
You stay here. Don't you dare leave here before I get back. Do you understand?
Your friend lose something?
Where did you get those?
I sort of borrowed them last night.
Oh, that's why she's backed out. She didn't have her dose last night. Give those pills to me or
I'll... Oh, you'll what? Feel like taking on the three of us?
Look, you don't understand. She's a diabetic. She could die.
Tough. You could always try and take them back off us. What's up? Guts gone to Jelly Bee. Ex-Queen Bee with the royal jelly belly. Hey, we gotta go now. I don't have to warn you about keeping your trap shut about these, do I? You above all know what happens to laggards.
Out of the way, Smith.
What's the trouble?
The pills that she was issued with last night are missing. That's why she's blacked out.
But they aren't missing. They were stolen.
Now, we can't jump to conclusions, Smith. She might have forgotten where she left.
But they were stolen, I know.
Oh, come on, Smith. What sort of an animal would do something like that?
Well, animal's right. It was that Margot woman. She was standing at the door just a few minutes before you arrived, tossing the pills in the air and daring me to do something about it.
If what you say is true, the staff will handle it. I do not want the prisoners involved.
But it is true. She was here just a few seconds ago with the pills. If you go after her now, you'll catch her with them on her.
Getting rid of the evidence.
Get lost. I'll deal with you later.
No, you'll deal with me now. What sort of monster are you? Taking a diabetic's pills. What's she ever done to you?
Don't give me the hearts and flowers bit. You know the system better than anyone else. She crossed me. I warned her I'd get her.
I don't know what system you're talking about, but if it includes letting an ill woman die because she can't take her medicine, then it ought to be changed.
You're really one for the books, you know, Smith. What's got into you? You found God or something?
No, I found hell. Now, you're coming with me and you're going to bring those pills.
Where to?
The governor's office.
Now listen to me, you lagging bitch. I don't know what your little scheme is, and I don't care. So if you think you're taking me to the governor's office, or anywhere else for that matter, you're in for one hell of a shock.
You come with me if I have to drag you.
You have slipped your trolley. You have gone right over the edge. They're gonna have to redecorate your cell with padded walls. Now get lost before I cream you.
Listen! You're...
Not as easy as you thought, eh, big shot.
Get off me! Get off! What's going on in here? Get up! Smith, get up! Now give me an explanation.
This maniac tried to kill me!
I found her with Mum's pills. She was on a bus down the sink.
I just found them. I was about to take them back, and this lunatic rushes in about screaming.
All right, give me the pills.
Get back to your cell, Smith. Any more of this, and you'll both do a stint in solitary. Now get out!
What are you two doing around here? Beat it, would you?
Hang on, Bev. I've got a much better idea. Something that'll throw the whole place into a panic. Come on,
right.
Come on.
Come on, Mrs. Smith, we got something real special for you.
But they never give us dessert.
Oh, me! What is it? Where are you?
Miss Bennett, get the others back to Master, then let the others out of their cells.
She'll be all right.
Yeah, she'll be all right, Brian. I'll take her to see the sister and then the governor.
Now, come on, will you move out? Will you shut up and get going?
But you must have some idea who it was.
I never had a chance. They came at me from behind.
Yes, but surely you saw them at some stage. You must have.
No, honestly, Mr. Fletcher, it all happened so fast. It was just a blur of arms and feet. Then I passed out. And I woke up on the floor of that awful storeroom.
Well, it's obvious somebody has it in for you, and if you can't or won't help us, I have no alternative but to lock you up for your own protection. Mr. Fletcher, Smith will be confined to her cell until further notice.
How you feeling, Mrs. Smith? A bit sore, are you? How'd you like your little rest in the storeroom?
Look, I understand you. Why don't you just leave me alone? What do you want?
I want you to know I'm the boss. And if I get any more trouble out of you, I'll arrange another little party for you.
Already, Margot!
Well, thanks for the bashing, because that's just what I needed, a thump on the head, and neither of us knew it. Oh, yes, Margot. I'm back. The funny thing is, we're the only two that know it. And we're going to keep it that way. Because if I play my cards right, I'm going to get out of here for good. No, we are going to keep my little secret, aren't we? Because if you don't, so help me, I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
Hey, that's Beast, you know. I was saving it for her.
Well, she's not here, is she?
There she is. Hey, Beast, come over here and get your dinner. I've been saving it for you.
It's nice to have friends, isn't it, Smith? Now go and get your dinner.
No. If you come in now, Mrs. Brooks, you'll be locked in till the morning.
Well, I'm not going anywhere.
Very well, then. Good night.
Good night. Habit's a funny thing, isn't it, Bec?
What?
I said, habit's a funny thing. You're pacing up and down the cell just the way you used to all those years ago.
I don't remember.
Oh, I know you don't. As I said, it's just habit. Like Margot in the dining room. She knows she's got no reason to be scared of you anymore, but she didn't fight with you over that dinner, did she? Oh, well, it's just habit. Very hard to break one's habits.
What's the idea of letting me have that dinner last night?
Well, you wanted it, didn't you?
I am supposed to be scared of you, not the other way around. Mum noticed it. So did Vera. Any more mistakes and the whole prison will know.
What am I supposed to do?
Just act like the moron you are, Margot. As if you ran the place. You've been doing it for the last couple of weeks. Shouldn't be too difficult. Any more mistakes, and you'll be sorry.
I asked you what you were talking
about. Leave her alone, Margot.
You want to make something of it?
Just leave her alone.
I will, when she tells me what she was talking about. Speak up, Dora. I can't hear you. Would a buyer of this be? Everyone's watching to see what you'll do.
It's none of my business.
I thought not.
Now, do you recognize this woman?
Yes, that's Beryl. We used to run the salon together.
Used to?
Well, until I woke up in this place and found myself on the run from the police.
She was a friend of your husband's, wasn't she?
Well, she's a friend of the whole family's. We go down to the beach and on picnics and everything.
You don't remember her having an affair with your husband? And that's why you killed her?
No, I don't.
All right, well, we'll move on to something else. Your daughter, Debbie. Do you remember the circumstances of her death?
No. What am I going to do, Mum?
Talk to your father.
He's kicked me out, Mum. He brought some woman home about 2 months ago and told me to get out.
Oh, really? Help, Debbie. Someone has got to help me.
I wanted you to help me, Mum.
Mrs. Smith.
I don't remember.
Look, I appreciate how difficult this must be for you, but you understand we've got to go through it. I've got to know exactly how much you don't remember. Now, it seems to cover a considerable length of time, more than 10 years.
Look, can a bump on the head do that to you, Doctor?
Well, not entirely, no. But you see, the knock on the head was just a trigger. The mind itself shuts off any memories that may be too, well, unhappy to remember. The mind's protecting you.
Funny sort of protection, leaving me like this.
Well, it may work in more ways than one. I've already discussed the situation with your solicitor. Now, he feels if you can't remember being in prison, then you can't be held responsible for escaping. He thinks you should get off without any further sentence.
What happens after the trial? Do I have to come back here?
I'm afraid so. Although, if your memory doesn't return, there's a very strong argument for you being released later on. Well, doesn't seem to make you very happy.
Oh, I'm sorry, Doctor. I suppose I'm just becoming like the rest of the women in here. My roommate, Mrs. Brooks, she says that once you get in here, you never get out.
Well, in this case, we may just prove her wrong.
What's the matter? Didn't he believe you?
Oh, yes, he believed me, right?
Then why so glum?
He showed me the coroner's report and how Debbie died.
That made you feel guilty, did it? Using Debbie's memory like that. Well, you've used so many people, I wouldn't have thought one more would make any difference.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, come off it, Bea. I know you'd lost your memory when you arrived at my place, but you've got it back now. What's the point? Now you're just using it to try and get out of here, and you don't care who gets hurt in the process. How you could stand by and let Margot beat up young Doreen, I don't know.
Well, you were there too.
Well, I couldn't have stopped her. You could.
What was I supposed to do? Give myself away and spend the rest of my life rotting in here just to save Doreen a beating? She's had plenty.
There was a time when your friends always would have come first.
Yeah, well, things changed. There was a time when you had some guts. But you're not even going to fight in court tomorrow. If you think what I let Margot do to Doreen was bad, it's nothing to what's going to happen to you in court. You could die in here.
But I've got no choice.
You could say you were too frightened to go to the police. You could say I threatened to kill you.
And what would that do to your case?
Nothing. I had lost my memory. I don't remember a thing. Mum, you've got to fight. You can't let them grind us into the dirt. Don't worry, I won't let Margot hit Doreen again.
Well, how will you manage it without giving yourself away?
Oh, don't you worry. I'll manage it. All right, you two, get lost.
You heard her.
What's up, Bea? You ran out of coffee.
Don't try and be smart, Margot. It doesn't suit you. I've come to warn you. All this stuff about being top dog, you are laying it on too thick.
How do you mean?
I mean like thumping Doreen and trying to make me light your cigarettes. Just remember, you're only pretending.
But I'm not, Bea, am I? You're the one that's pretending. You think you're top dog, but you can't enforce it. And if you can't enforce it, you haven't got it, have you? So give us a light, would you?
I can enforce anything I want! Now, just remember, all I have to do is wait till the screws are down. Now, don't thump Doreen, and don't try and make me light your cigarettes! And just remember, you are only pretending!
Here, Margot, you haven't finished your coffee.
Oh, Margot, you're so careless.
Mrs. Morris, on the second occasion that Smith visited Mrs. Brooks' home, the occasion when she was actually arrested there, did Mrs. Brooks advise you that Smith had returned?
No, but there wouldn't have been time.
Mrs. Morris, just answer the question, yes or no. Did Mrs. Brooks advise you that Smith had returned?
No.
No. She didn't advise the police either. Thank you, Mrs. Morris. No further questions.
Thank you, Mrs. Morris. You may step down.
Blast! I may still get off. I've still got my own evidence to give.
Oh, yeah, and they're going to listen to you, aren't they? Especially after the way our counsel has managed to get right up the judge's nose. It's not fair. You've tried to do the right thing by everyone. It looks like you're going to go down.
It looks like I'm going to get away with it.
Well, you've worked very hard for it, Bea.
Yeah, well, it's not fair.
Hey, you out there. Come on, open up.
Yeah.
I want to speak to our counsel.
He's at lunch. All right. I'll see if I can find him.
Bea, what's the point of speaking to him?
I'm going to testify for you. I can't stand by and let you go back to jail.
Mrs. Smith, would you kindly make your statement to the court?
I went to Mum's Mrs. Brooks' house. And I threatened her.
And why was that, Mrs. Smith?
Because I wanted her to help me with my escape.
Do you mean to tell the court that you were in full possession of your faculties? That you knew who you were? That you were not, in fact, suffering from amnesia?
Well, I did have amnesia after the crash. That's why I went wandering off. But by the time I got to town, it had worn off and I could remember where Mum lived.
This is most extraordinary. I cannot believe that a psychiatrist of Dr. Weissman's experience could have been duped so easily.
Well, it was having amnesia in the first place that gave me the idea. I thought that if I played along after I was caught, I couldn't be held responsible.
I see.
Which means Mum isn't responsible. I threatened her and she...
Thank you, Mrs. Smith. Mrs. Brooks can speak for herself. Well, Mrs. Brooks, is this true?
Yes, Your Honor.
Then why have you not mentioned it before?
Well, I was afraid. B. Smith has a reputation for violence. I was afraid that when she got out again, well, she would make sure I paid for contradicting her story about having amnesia.
I see. Mr. Waller, do you wish to question Brooks or Smith?
Oh, may it please, Your Honor, the prosecution would request a short recess.
The court will reconvene at 3 o'clock.
All stand.
In light of Mrs. Smith's statement, the prosecution has agreed to drop the charges against Mrs. Brooks. You may step down. Mrs. Smith, do you have anything to say in defense of your actions or anything to add to your statement?
No, Your Honor.
The evidence given in this court shows that you attempted, willfully and knowingly, to thwart the course of justice. The fact that you succeeded in duping an experienced psychiatrist bears out the view that you are a cunning and habitual liar. One prison officer was killed and one seriously injured while you were being escorted from Barnhurst to Wentworth. From the evidence given by the surviving officer, it would appear that you had nothing to do with the accident. And while it is not inconceivable that you suffer temporary amnesia, your statement here today leads me to agree wholeheartedly with the jury. I therefore sentence you to 18 months penal servitude for escaping from legal custody to be served concurrently with your present sentence.
Heard the latest?
Yes, Mrs. Morris phoned. When did you get your memory back?
Just between you and me?
Just between us.
When I was shoved in that storeroom, something clicked. Reminded me of being in the tunnel. Seems funny, doesn't it, an old lag like me getting claustrophobia after all the time I've been locked up?
I'd like to say that what you did was rather courageous. I'm sure Mum thinks so too.
Yeah, well, doesn't matter anymore, does it? It's all over.
Well, you'd better go and have your shower now.